हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू केबीआई के ऑनलाइन स्टडी चैनल। आज सर रामाशीष मौर्य योर केमिस्ट्री टीचर। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कैथोड रेज। बिफोर दैट वी लर्न अबाउट द कैथोड रे एक्सपेरिमेंट। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिस्कवरी ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स and the characteristics of anode rays. J.J. Thomson, the scientist who discovered the electrons by performing the cathode ray experiment. After his experiment, the German scientist E. Goldstein performed the same experiment, but he did in his experiment Goldstein modified the discharge tube. In his experiment, the Goldstein took the discharge tube with perforated cathode. You can see here, there are holes in the cathode. And the hydrogen gas was filled at low pressure in the discharge tube. When the high voltage current was passed through the electrodes of the discharge tube, here you can see it is connected to the source of voltage, where it is cathode and this one is anode. So when the high voltage current was passed through the discharge tube, some rays emitted from the anode passed through the holes of this cathode and produced green fluorescence here on the zinc sulfide coating. You can see some rays are passing from the holes of the cathode and they produce green fluorescence on the zinc sulfide coating, which is opposite side to the anode. So these rays are called anode rays or cathode rays. Now we will discuss about characteristics of anode rays. Anode rays also travel in straight line, or we can say anode rays travel at straight path. Anode rays consist of positively charged particles, that is protons. Because you can see these rays come toward the cathode, and we know that positively charged particles go toward the negative discharge. So cathode is a negative charge, so these positively charged particles called protons come to the towards the cathode. The nature of the anode rays depend on the nature of the gas which is filled in the discharge tube. In the cathode ray experiment, the ratio of the charge and mass of the particle was always constant. But in anode ray experiment, when it was checked, the ratio of the charge and mass of the particle was different for the different gases. So we can say that different particles have different types of atom and they produce different types of anode rays. So these are the characteristics of anode rays, and by anode rays we found the proton, because anode rays travel toward the cathode. One more characteristic: when the electric field is applied near the discharge tube, the anode rays will be deflected towards the negative plate of the electric field, because anode rays consist of the positively charged part. So today we discussed about discovery of Afrikaans and characteristics of Enoch. That's all. Thank you.